Hello there, sign of Taurus. My name is Kim and I'll do your reading. This will be for your weekend, so that's January 23rd and 24th, 2021. Thank you for watching, liking, sharing, subscribing, commenting. We're gonna call in Divine White Light to surround us as we do the reading and surround you as you watch the reading. Calling in our angel, spirit guide, higher self, higher power to help us with this reading. Okay, so let's get going, Taurus. See what we've got. We have the Poet. So, yeah, if you are a writer, then this is the card for you. If you're not, then just think about the word poetry, what that means to you. You know, everything kind of flowing. Okay, the truth teller, the artist, or the witness is what this card's about. Clairvoyant, wise, and timeless. These people that are under this poet archetype, they feel immensely and they seek out truth in the darkest corners of the world. So, the poet's work, let's see. Says it may, the words of the poet may ring true for centuries to come, soothing the wounds of the despair and the violence that captivate our world. The poet's work is never finished, so find your voice and trust that the wind will carry it. All right. So, the poets. Let's get some oracle cards. We're gonna get oracle cards first, and then we'll use the Rider-Waite tarot to shuffle and see where they land and kind of read them like that. All right, for Taurus. Uh-oh. Chaos and conflict on one hand. Okay, sorry about that. And this is exactly what you think it is. It's chaos and conflict, like the energy of the Five of Swords. So it's not the best energy to be in. It is an energy that is better to avoid. Let's get a spell casting card for Taurus. I'm interested to see what does the tarot have to say about chaos and conflict for Taurus? Okay, manifestation and forgiveness. Something that's being created, someone to be forgiven, chaos and conflict. All right, let's get some energy cards now too. And then we'll finish up and we'll finish our reading with the tarot. Ah. Oh goodness, Taurus. Wow, it's a good card though. I think you're gonna have victory over this chaos and conflict. It looks like you're gonna have victory over this. So whatever this is in your life, you are winning. Okay, Healer of the Ages. And of course, this is, you know, whatever it means to you. I won't place any of my views onto you. All right. So maybe in the need for a healing, may have like healing, winning over chaos and conflict, forgiveness, love, kindness. That might be kind of prevailing over all of this stuff. Let's see what the tarot has to say. Taurus. More Taurus. Okay, chaos and conflict is the tower. We've got the tower, so that kind of makes sense that we would get the tower for that. Sudden disruption of something. Sudden disruption. What else? What else, Taurus? I mean, we have a victory here, though. So, I don't know what this is. Okay, so here's going to be probably for this top row, I would think. We have chaos and conflict. We have Five of Swords energy, which is exactly, you know, that's that energy itself. And then we have inspiration that comes in and kind of maybe changes things up. We have you finding your Ten of Cups and family ultimately being the most important thing to you. So there's something that got really shook up. Something that got shook up, and it's acknowledging conflict, and then it just goes right into almost like a manifestation. Something really good comes out of something really dark, really not so good. Let's see, what else can we get? Ooh. All right, we have King of Pentacles as like on top of what, you know, what you have manifested or what you're going to manifest. This is someone who's really good with their money. Somebody, he has his own empire. He's like a, not empire, he's like the patriarch of the family. Let's see what else. Woo. Forgiveness. Maybe for a Gemini, or forgiveness for a partnership. A partnership. So either romance or business, if there's forgiveness that's entering into this situation with this decision, it will help you. It'll clear all the negative and bad things from yourself. And we have really on the manifestation and forgiveness, we have the Two of Cups. So another reference to Gemini too. All right. This is pretty heavy. I'm gonna do some tea leaves for you and wrap this up. Then I'll have your daily reads after the weekend. All right, so we have Feather. Someone you know is undependable and insincere. Bread, a period of prosperity and abundance. And that's what's coming after this sudden change, this disruption. And I can't tell you, you know, if that's, it looks like it's in the past, but I can't really tell you how far back that goes. You would know. I, psychic ability, trust your intuition. July and November for someone. All right, thank you so much, Taurus. You all have a good night. Sending love and light to you. Bye.